Hey everyone, this is the Lego Ninjago Cole Box. I believe in the United States, this is a Toys R Us exclusive. That's where I got mine. I just had a whole bunch of these on an end cap. And it comes just like this. This is the entire set. This is the retail box for it. And I'm just gonna go ahead and unbox it right here because I want to show you the experience of what all you get with this. It just has a single piece of tape across the front there. And looks like there are going to be two doors that open. Yes, and the scene, actually folds out even further. There we go. And his sword is just in place. Get this zoomed out a little bit. There we go. So that's the presentation. I'm personally not big into packaging, but I think this is a pretty presentable and potentially collectible package, at least for the sake of display. And let me just go ahead and get the pieces out and give you a closer look at the figure, because that's the main thing in here. Looks like it's a little bit stuck. Oh, that's good. Up. Oh, okay, so we'll just be looking at the legs by themselves. No. There we go. So this is Cole in stone armor from the rebooted season back in late 2014, early 2015. And I went back to my reviews of all the sets from that season, because I could have sworn we got one of these back then, but no, we did not. This is the first time to get a Cole in stone armor, so that makes it special and makes it make a lot of sense to release it as just an individual thing for, you know, pretty serious fans of Ninjago. Previously, I just hadn't looked it up before I actually bought the thing, but yeah, that's actually nice. And the last stone armored ninja that we got was Kai, who came in that Target exclusive 4-pack of different figures from different series. And they've used the same design for the torso, and they changed out the animal, you know, insignia in the center, and of course the colors. And the hip print is different and the leg print is different, because Cole actually gets some chainmail, kind of chainmail plates, it looks like, on his upper legs on either side. Looks like those might be kind of embedded into leather, have, you know, leather flaps behind them or something. And then he also has the actual buckles down below. And those either help to hold on the leg armor, or that might actually be for the boots. Yeah, this works out pretty well. There's only one thing that I don't like about this armor set that they've come up with. From this angle, it looks better. What I'm specifically looking at is the color of the corner right there. That corner, and then that corner right there. So right now it matches with the pauldrons when you look at it with the light actually reflecting off of it well. But from most angles, just, you know, in normal display outside of the studio here, it looks darker like that, you know. And in the show, those were really shiny. They were very bright. I kind of wish that they had chosen the brightest silver, which they've used for the chain and chain mail parts and all the highlights. You know, I think that large areas of that would have looked good, but it would have had less contrast. So it's a little bit of a trade-off in that sense. Let me take some of this stuff off. I did notice that the joints feel a little bit loose on this relative to a normal figure. And that goes for the legs as well, legs and the arms. The hands, not so much, but the legs and arms, for sure. So that's just, you know, where it comes from. I'm sure that these promotional and special edition items are usually done by the contractor factory in China, which has a little bit different quality, uses slightly different materials. But overall, it doesn't feel bad. You know, the materials don't feel bad, but I think you can see just a little bit of the satin finish. It's a little bit different from what you normally get from Lego, from their main line stuff. Good printing on the back. You know, it's just appropriate. It's just what you would expect from this armor set. And again, you know, same colors are used, and if you angle it, you get to see that extra shine from the corners. Yep, so it's pretty much everything that you would want out of a stone armored Cole, except for maybe, you know, an alternate face. So that's pretty nice. It is definitely a bit expensive for just a single figure, and I personally don't put much value in the packaging. You know, I don't want to pay extra for the packaging, but given that it is a special kind of limited edition item that is specifically made for strong and longer term fans of the series, I think that the price is reasonable and not too many people will balk at it for what it is. Let me know what you think though, what you think of the figure and its price and distribution, and I will get to work on more videos to share with you very soon. So thank you very much for watching. I'll catch you later.